This is taking bloody ages.
Time go.
Get a breather.
This is it, you bunch of pansies. The cards are shuffled. Now, place your bet.
Feeding him his own nets.
Looks strange. What? Unreal even.
Who are you? Stay away from my family. They know nothing of the wizard. Take me! A source hunter? Lodion, the gods have answered our prayers. I can think of no more welcome deliverer from this predicament than one of your esteemed order. Seven bless us, and you too. Aye, we three labored under Xandalore's employ. He was right decent to us, and it's thanks to him we managed to escape the brutes upstairs. Xandalore prepared this hidden place long ago. It's almost as though he knew, somehow, that this day would come. Or perhaps he knew only that the forces of evil would always pursue those of goodness and light. Many years ago, he told us that if ever we found ourselves in danger, we should flee to this cellar. Shut fast its door, he said, and mark the jamb with a chalk pentangle. This will call forth the magic I have assigned for your protection. Xandalore is a brilliant man, even among wizards. Why he chose to settle in this sleepy little town, I can't say. But then again, he never did remain for long. Always dashing off to attend to some matter or other, our wizard. We cared for his home while he was away, and attended to him when he was in. We were quite fond of him, and I do believe he was rather fond of us too. It seems that when we triggered this cellar's defenses, he knew straight away. Within a minute or so, a strange orb of light appeared before us. It grew sharper and sharper about the edges. I held out my hands to grasp it, and it fell, heavy as a pearl, in my hands. From the orb came Xandalore's voice, clear and strong as though he were standing just before me. His voice was hurried, strained in a way I'd never heard before. Something unthinkable. That he was traveling through the Phantom Forest, that heart of horrors, and into the ancient source temple that rests within its cursed depths. He told us to wait for the White Witch, asked us to deliver a message, something important by the sound of it. We wrote it down, word for word, and will pass it along whenever it is she comes. Kara's blessing! Xandalore has the same. I'd recognize it anywhere. So the White Witch sent you, did she? I should have known she'd not sit idly by while the world turned topsy-turvy. Xandalore's message is as such. He's gone to the Source Temple in the Phantom Forest, and he wants her, or I suppose you, her messengers, to follow him there. In order to enter the forest, you'll need an amulet. He stored it in a small chest near his personal waypoint. Once you're inside the forest, you'll need to find the forest spirit. This spirit will give you the rune you need to enter the Source Temple. But first things first, if you want to get inside Xandalore's house, you'll need to use the portal in this very room. I've the crystal you need still. Entering the house will be the least of your worries. Xandalore himself has called forth every manner of protection to discourage would-be intruders, and you will have to defeat them all in order to reach the bedroom. Now, the last thing he said doesn't make much sense to an outsider. Perhaps you or the witch will manage to make better sense of it. He said, and I quote, "She is coming. I only hope I can reach the temple first. If she finds the portal..." He didn't finish after that. I know little more than its name implies, but if a temple of source does indeed rest within that blighted forest, a greater evil I cannot imagine. Many is the year since ghoul or beast has ventured out of the defiled sanctuary of those woods, yet still we of the village dare not enter. Legend says that to set a single foot into the Phantom Forest is to invite death's grasp. It's a legend none wish to test. As you may know, this town was founded as the last bulwark against the source monstrosities that reside within that terrible place. After the fall of Bracchus Rex, the defeated darkness retreated to those woods, and haunted they have remained ever since. Before you go, perhaps we might impose on you, well, a favor. Source Hunter, we need a way out of this place. It's only a matter of time before the savages upstairs find us. And trying to leave through the village is as good as suicide. But Xandalore has his own means of travel, a waypoint shrine in his own chambers reserved for his personal use. If we could only get there, we'd be able to flee this place lickety-split. The only trouble is what I've already mentioned. The wizard's house is rigged from top to bottom. If you'll be disabling its defenses, we'll slip through without problem. Good luck, Source Hunter. And unimaginable thanks from me and mine.
Where am I? Am I... Is this real?
I feel as though I've been living in a dream. I was bathing myself, as I've done a million times over, when suddenly a curious sensation...
Is this one of them fancy scribble pages? Never did trust them myself.
Hello again. Do you bring good news? They've survived this carnage so far by concealed savage... But you're not... They must be squashed. Every last...
Thank you. scroll of revelation? There must be something of some value hidden here. Doesn't seem to work here. What's this? It looks strange. Scroll of revelation? There must be something of some value hidden here.
I feel better already!
What's this? It looks strange.
Treasure, treasure on the ground. Who's the grandest dame in town? What a horn-loving dog you are! I won't hear such nonsense. No, indeed, an orc isn't really a dame in any case, is it? Treasure, treasure on the ground. Who's the grandest dame in I suppose if you're titillated by the brutalization of our beloved language, Nardi is the proper choice for you. Treasure, treasure on that carnivorous farmhand.
Doesn't seem to work here.
Thank you.
doesn't seem to work here. Drenched. As good as a new penny. Defenses shut down, the family should be able to get through here without a hitch. How very strange to see a friendly face in these dark times. Strange, but welcome. A cat told you. I don't know much about source hunters, but I never knew them to be... Well, if what you say is true, it must be Jinxica to whom you spoke. How wonderful to hear she lives. I feared she'd been lost to the orcs or the wilds, but it seems our kind... We called for old Jinxie before going into hiding. But this little stray here was the only one who showed up. I figured better to save one little whiskered friend than none.
Our friend, how can we help you? Not much to see.
Make yourself at home for the present. We haven't much to offer.
Our friend, how can we help you? Oh, yes, let's! Have you cleared a path to Zandalore's shrine? Great gods above! That's fantastic news! Psst. Before we go, I might be able to offer you a little tip. When I was cleaning the wizard's guest rooms, I'd often hear him whisper Ikara to a locked chest in his chamber.
Check beneath these boards. Any sign of them?
None here. No into that secret cellar either. Who would have thought Flatland would be so clever?
Well, keep looking. We'll rip out every board.
Hello again. Do you bring good news? They've survived this carnage, savage.
But you're not.
They must be squashed. Every last one.
I feel like I've just had a long back.
Treasure on the ground. Who's the grand? Aren't you a dear? What is it you like best about that lovely lady? The sweet cadence of her voice? Her fair grace? The whole package has impressed you, I do suppose. Well chosen indeed.
The thing won't budge. Right, you round girls.
What are you doing lingering around here anyway, human?
Brutilda doesn't tell you a thing, does she? We're waiting to fight the final battle. You there, tell me, how's your vision? Any ailments in the liver or spleen? I am a servant to the goddess, of course. One of the first among her enlightened in Revelon, and certainly the most devoted. I've scoured the region for unworthy souls, and am quite efficient. How much better the lost serve her as bone automatons. My expertise as a necromancer is unmatched, you know. I've a success rate is nearing 99%. They end up with their brains a bit, well, scrambled. You can find such a fellow opining over skulls somewhere around here. One of my more harmless false steps, I think. There, again the lost one struts by.
You won't admire my work, my shapely physique. Well, get it on, kid. Perfectly disciplined, man.
Huge discounts on magic fool. My organ, anything and everything left behind by vermin after we've back again, I see. Have the elements world beyond your control? Fear not, I've every scroll you need. Soon the flames will dance at your behest, and yours alone.
Three of you there, single bloke. Finally, I have a bloody fed again.
You've got to the count of one to kneel before me.
Behind a worthy scrap or two.
Don't talk to the smallbones, brother. It only makes eating them all of this pleasant labor.
Freshen this.
Of course! Oh, mother, of course!
Human haggis. Been too long, hasn't it, brother?
Even vermin leave behind a worthy scrap or two.
Hurry it up with the whiskey. You fetch your git in your throat, slit.
Well, I got three little bad.
I've got my eyes on the prize.
What can I do for you, so?
And so let the...
I've got my eyes on the prize.
Did someone leave an oven door open?
Of course, they'll be the moment.
Vermin could harbor such useful relics.
I've got my eyes.
I'm drenched.
Don't talk to the small boats, brother. It only makes eating them all of this pleasant later.
Maybe for you. Me? I'd like to know a bit about my
Many rats scurrying in and out of this hole. where it leads is uncertain.
And it won't be much longer yet.
You're just a human, and he's Jim Crow, as we say. Side word. You're just a human, and he...
soaked to the skin!
Truhul Exil Titan Griva. Exegeter. Truhul Exil Titan Griva.